Well, just 48 hours ago, we told you about a shocking fake nude photo scandal rocking a school in regional Victoria. Well, now this humiliating and criminal form of bullying has struck New South Wales.
A male student at Hunter School of Performing Arts on the state's north coast has turned innocent images of girls as young as 12 into explicit photographs using artificial intelligence. Despite being caught with 300 of these photos on his phone, all he received was a 10-day suspension and he's now back at school. Parents are furious, but experts say nothing will change until perpetrators see clear and serious consequences.
Well, let's bring in cyber safety expert Susan McLean now and adolescent psychologist Deirdre Brander. Morning to you both. Susan, to you first. A 10-day suspension for something like this, the thing that bothers me most about that is that the victims of this crime have now got to be in school and seeing this person on a daily basis.
Correct. And I think it's absolutely appalling that that is happening. There comes a time when young people behave in such a way that the rights of one student to remain do not and must not outweigh the rights of the rest of the community to be safe. Schools have a legal, it's a law, a legal duty of care through common law to ensure a safe learning environment. And while that boy is at the school, those girls are not safe. They might be safe physically, but they're not safe mentally, and that's equally as important.
Deirdre, take us through some of the reasoning behind why a student would choose to do this, to make these fake nude photos and share them.
We know that young people are faced with technological advances that are faster than we can even comprehend. So it starts off as curiosity around, you know, nudity and images, but then it becomes living out a fantasy world. And unfortunately, the lines between what happens online and what happens in the real world are really blurred on this, and moral reasoning seems to go out the window.
So, Deirdre, how damaging are these scandals?
It's very, very damaging, particularly for these victims, because it is a form of sexual abuse. We know that studies show that the people who are victims of this feel shame, exploitation, it leads to anxiety, it leads to depression. And they're left wondering, where are these images going to show up again and what's going to be the long-term impact on my life and my digital footprint?
Susan, if students decide to do this type of behaviour, fake or not, could they be charged?
Absolutely, because the one good thing about our laws is when we talk about the manufacture or the making of child abuse material, it covers a real image, a fake image, an AI image. It covers anime and cartoons. And last night I read an article about a Sydney bartender, an adult, so it's not just a kid thing, who did this to female friends of his, and he is now going to jail.
Wow.
Deirdre, laws and regulations are going to take a long time to control this situation. What can people do to help now?
It's critical that as parents we start to have these conversations. Don't wait for an expert. Sit down and have calm conversations, not lectures. It's about empowering our children. It's not about scaring them, because whether they are a victim or a bystander, we need them to know that they can come to us with what's going on. We can have conversations about this, and it doesn't mean that we're going to take their phone off them.
Tech companies, social media companies need to come to the party as well. Susan, Deirdre, thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Pleasure.